oftentimes people who don't fit in with the popular crowd are going to be the people who are not conformists. Because what is popularity if not conformity?
Yeah.
What do I need to do for acceptance? How do I need to be? Your capacity for love is endless, but for it to last, it has to be mutual. For it to last, it has to be reciprocal.
They're not falling in love in this montage. They're each getting to a point where they can fall in love with each other.
Real love is respect. You don't want to actually change who you are to win someone's affections. Yes, improve for someone. Yes, grow for someone. But there's a difference between that and who I actually am and who the front I'm putting on.
Everybody our age can quote Princess Bride at each other.
Yeah, yeah.
And
this deserves it.
This deserves that. Like, it's such a fun, sweet, just delightful movie.
You gotta look at what is, not what you wish was. And sometimes what is even better than what you had wished.
Welcome to Cinema Therapy. I am Alan Seawright, professional filmmaker who needs therapy, and this is...
Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. What's going on today?
This is a very special react. We ran a Kickstarter a few months ago so that I could make a short film, Moonstruck. It'll be on the Telekinesis channel, which is my company channel, sometime very soon, around the time this comes out. One of the backer tiers was you could be a producer of an episode of Cinema Therapy, and this is a movie that I've been wanting to talk about for a long time. So thank you, Ian, for backing Moonstruck. And I'm going to have you react to Stardust.
What aspects do you want me to be looking at here?
What I would like to do is maybe compare the relationships between Tristan and Yvain and Tristan and Victoria.
No, it's Tristan.
Oh. Did I leave something at the shop?
No, I just thought I could...
Tristan Thorne.
Terrible peripheral vision.
Peeping Tom by night.
It's a movie. I don't have time to explain to you how movies work, Jono.
He's Daredevil, though. He's blind. How did he not see?
Should have heard him.
Those for Victoria. You were always useless at fencing in school, Tristan.
I had a similar experience asking a girl to prom.
Trouble remembering if there was anything you were good at.
A douchebag hit you with a stick?
No. Yeah, there was fencing.
Okay, I need to hear this story
fencing
off the
and
air.
Flowers.
Yeah, fine.
So, this is where we get into something called simp culture.
Talk to me.
Simp culture is the idea that there is a man, generally, a man will do anything to win a woman's affections, including... being mistreated, being disrespected.
Sure.
Just to show that no matter what, he is here for her, no matter what, he will go above and beyond. And generally, she's not interested back.
Right.
And generally, he gets treated poorly. That's the stereotypical gender. This can go in any direction, generally.
Yeah.
But when you simp after somebody, the feeling isn't reciprocated.
Right.
And real love is respect. Right? And
sure.
She does not show him any respect. She laughs when he gets bludgeoned, and then he laughs, you know, from the ground. Like,
it was funny. I got beat up, I guess.
You know, we spend a lot of time watching movies, and this dad bod needs someplace comfy for movie marathoning.
Boy, we are so excited to partner with Allform for this video. I'm not excited to see that again.
You've heard me talk about my awesome Helix mattress. Well, I just got a sofa from their sister company, Allform. It is amazing for my movie marathons.
Allform has sofas and chairs that are American-made, easy to assemble, and you can customize them to fit in any space that you may have in your house or domicile.
Plus, they're scratch and sniff resistant.
Scratch and stain resistant is what he meant to say, which is super important because you have a lot of kids, I have a lot of kids, I also have some dogs. You can personalize your sofa to your space and style with over 500 unique combinations. You can find something to perfectly fit the size and space of your room.
Or your butt.
If you're starting in a small space.
Or a small butt.
Your sofa can grow with you. You can just buy pieces later to add on to your sofa.
Like butt implants.
It is so easy to buy online.
And Allform ships to your door for free.
Setup is quick and easy.
And that's actually my favorite thing about the experience of ordering from them, because as you probably know, I struggle with the type of interconnected block. I have a hard time with this type of stuff. And actually putting together this furniture and assembling it in the combinations that I designed, I was actually able to show up and get it done.
Hey!
It's actually a big deal.
If you're nervous to buy something that you haven't rubbed your booty on, If you're nervous to buy something you haven't tried before, good news, Allform has a 100-day trial. That means you have more than 3 months to decide whether or not you like it, and if you don't, they will pick it up from you and give you a full, not partial, but full refund.
That's awesome. I love my Allform sofa, and I think that you will too. So if you're looking for new seating, give Allform a try. Go to allform.com/cinematherapy to get 20% off the sofa of your choice. Have you seen that haircut though? He had it coming. Like, we're gonna get...
He really did. Pre-Robert De Niro hair care Tristan versus post-Robert De Niro hair care Tristan.
The single most important hair transformation of any film I've ever seen.
Ever.
Yeah, it really does so much for the character.
He really, she's all that at him.
If you are being treated like dirt, don't keep going.
Oh, is that?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not gonna go well.
Interesting.
Because even if they do end up choosing you, they're only going to choose you because they want someone they can keep treating like dirt.
Oh, look, I'm sorry about last night. Humphrey was really rude. I also need a sack of potatoes and some chocolate, please.
May I perhaps see you tonight?
No, but you may walk me home.
I will allow it.
Now?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yes, I can.
But you're on shift. You're on shift at work.
Father, I lost my job. Father, I lost my job, I'm sorry.
Oh, the power of editing.
You lost your job. Yes, so I heard.
Father.
Pre-lapping that joke over that guy's face. Just such a genius move.
Maybe I am deluding myself. I'm not good enough for Victoria.
He said that? That's poppycock.
You are deluding yourself, but it's not because you're not good enough for Victoria.
Not good. Come on, I'm wasting my time. I'm not like Humphrey.
Tristan, I can tell you that every man I ever envied when I was a boy has led an unremarkable life. So you don't fit with the popular crowd. Now, I take that as a very good omen.
The idea that that if you don't fit in with the popular crowd, I see that as a good omen.
Mm-hmm.
Because oftentimes people who don't fit in with the popular crowd are going to be the people who are not conformists. Because what is popularity if not conformity?
Yeah.
What do I need to do for acceptance? How do I need to be? And generally speaking, it means that I either don't know myself or I bury myself to be something else.
There is a reason there are zero movies about the cool kids in school actually being really cool. It's because no one in Hollywood was the cool kid.
There is exactly one movie about the cool kid actually being cool, and that is Ferris Bueller's Day Off. The difference is Ferris is good to everybody, and that's why people like him.
Ferris is good to everybody who's not an adult or an authority figure.
But how does a shop boy afford all of this?
So he got champagne for her.
Oh. God, I heard. I'm sorry. What are you going to do now?
I'm not a shop boy. I was just working in a shop. And now I'm not. Now I'm free to live my life as I wish.
This must have been all your savings.
So? That is great, though. I'm not a shop boy. I was working in a shop.
Working in a shop.
Stay in wool, Victoria. There's a big world out there. I'm going to make my fortune.
Oh, you sound just like Humphrey. He's quite a traveler. Do you know, he's going all the way.
If you're on a date with somebody and they're talking about somebody else that they find impressive, the date's not going well.
It's not going well, but he is going all the way to Ipswich.
Why is he
That's pretty impressive.
What kind of a ring?
The word is he's planning to propose to me on my birthday.
He's gonna... And you're gonna say yes?
I can't exactly say no. After he's gone all the way to Ipswich.
All the way to Ipswich?
After he's gone all the way to Ipswich. Oh, man.
Or continents.
So funny.
Really?
Yes. Victoria, for your hand in marriage, I would go to the gold fields of San Francisco and bring you back your weight in gold. I would.
Oh, man.
Africa and bring you back a diamond as big as your face.
I have had this date.
Or I'd go to the Arctic and I'd slaughter a polar bear and... bring you back its head.
Except for there was no alcohol.
A polar bear's head!
You blew it. You didn't say just the perfect thing.
People like you.
Also, you didn't promise me money.
Me, we just... not... I should be going. It's really late.
Well, here's the thing about...
Let's at least finish the champagne.
Sim situations. She does enjoy his company.
Sure.
The way you would enjoy a puppy.
Yeah.
You know? She thinks he's cute. He's kind of adorable. She has no intention of ever spending her life with him.
Yep.
Beautiful.
More beautiful than a fancy ring from Ipswich.
He's a pleasant distraction to her.
Yeah.
And she is everything to him.
For your hand in marriage, I'd cross the wall and I'd bring you back that fallen star.
You can't cross the wall. Nobody crosses the wall. Now you're just being silly.
I'm not being silly. I'd do it.
He's got this idea that some great deed, some grand gesture will win her heart.
And then everything will be perfect.
Love isn't earned. Love is, I am who I am, you are who you are, and we choose each other.
Well, are you all right? Do you want some help?
You can help by leaving me alone.
All right.
Claire Danes is such a delight in this movie.
Oh, she's so great.
Light the candle and think of me. I was thinking of my mother. But then Victoria and the star just popped into my...
Claire Danes is also the correct answer to, how do you cast someone prettier than Sienna Miller?
This may seem strange, but have you seen a fallen
star? It's very difficult to do, is the answer.
You're funny.
No, really, we're in a crater. This must be where it fell.
Yeah, this is where it fell. It is. Or, if you want to be really specific, up there's where this weird bloody necklace came out of nowhere and knocked it out of the heavens when it was minding its own business. And over there is where it landed. And right.
One of the few Americans who can pull off a British accent.
Got hit by a man.
Yeah, quite well.
Lying moron.
You're the star. You're the star? Really? Oh, wow. I'm sorry. I had no idea you'd be a... may I just say in advance that I am sorry.
I just love the world that this movie takes place in, where he finds out that a star became a person and he's just delighted by it.
Yeah. There's no processing time.
No, it's just like, oh, this is great. I love this.
This is romance, like the gift of a kidnapped, injured woman.
So, at some point, you may find yourself compromising your values. He's now a kidnapper.
Yeah. Yep.
Because he's simping so hard, he's now a kidnapper. Mm-hmm. And again, my opinion, if you have to change what you're all about to be with a person,
probably not a good fit.
This speaks more to Tristan's insecurity than to anything. This speaks more to, if I can get someone like this to love me,
that means whatever I have to be with her is probably great.
Yeah. And then I have value. And you already have value. You know, just because someone doesn't see it, and I love that this movie's going to get there, mm-hmm. that the people that we look up to, the people that we venerate and worship, they're just people.
Yeah.
Even if they're especially, you know, attractive, sometimes very attractive people are the worst. Like Alan.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm sitting down, I'm tired.
Please don't do this again. We agreed we'd stop off at the next village to eat and rest.
Come on, Tristan. It's midday. I never stay up this late. Just please, let me sleep.
Okay, you sleep. I'll go and get something to eat.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? Making sure you don't run away.
So they're not off to the best start. He kidnaps her. She's insulting him.
Yeah, not great.
It's a classic meet cute.
It's a classic kidnap cute.
It's how Alan and Megan met, you know?
I mean, yes.
If there's one thing I learned in all my years watching Earth, is that people aren't what they may seem. There are shop boys, and there are boys who just happen to work in shops for the time being. And trust me, Tristan, you're no shop boy. You saved my life. Thank you.
So this is the first scene where they open up and they're real and they're vulnerable.
Yeah.
And she sees him.
Yep.
Right? He tried to tell Victoria earlier on.
I mean, I'm not a shop boy. I was just working in a shop.
And the only thing she ever sees is the surface.
Oh, yeah. Which is
he
why
he doesn't dress as well as Humphrey. He's not going all the way to Ipswich to get me a ring.
Right?
He's, you know, he's not a fancy boy.
He's a real fancy boy.
Well, and in Humphrey, she sees potential.
Yeah.
Right? Because Humphrey would be a status symbol. She would be with him for what it would bring her in wealth or in prestige and, you know, they're a smart match. Whereas, and he thinks he's not good enough for Victoria. Mm. And yet here, a literal star, a celestial being, is falling for him because she sees just his innate goodness. Kidnapping aside, we all have our moments.
Listen, nobody's perfect.
Tell me about Victoria, then.
Well, she...
This is such a great scene.
There's nothing more to tell you.
The little I know about love is that it's unconditional. It's not something you can buy.
Hang on, this wasn't about me buying her love.
Yes, it was.
This was a way for me to prove how I felt.
Ah. And what's she doing to prove how she feels about you?
What? Look, Yvain, you'll understand when you meet her, all right? Provided we don't get murdered by pirates first.
Mm. Murdered by pirates, heart torn out and eaten. Meet Victoria. Can't quite decide which sounds more fun.
It's a beautiful character moment for Tristan. Obviously, he's starting to, you know, he's still denying it to himself, but he's starting to figure out, like, oh, I'm dumb.
Tell me about Victoria. Well, she's... Well, there's nothing more to tell.
There's nothing... You'll understand it when you meet her. Because you gotta look at her, and then you'll see that she's pretty, and that's what I like.
Yeah.
It's the pretty. One of the things that I noticed about this, and it's something that I find generally kind of obnoxious from most actors, and Claire Danes does it, and I love it, love it, love it.
What's that?
Huge expressions.
Yeah.
It looks like overacting.
Yeah.
Right? It looks like someone's really trying to show you their emotion. Like, it's just too much.
Like Jim Carrey getting electrocuted.
Jim Carrey does it for comedy, and it's great because his face is made of silly putty.
Yeah.
Generally speaking, in film, because you can punch into a close-up, you want to keep everything really small.
Yeah.
Because even
big face acting is for the stage.
It's for the stage. And even then, you still have to have a line to deliver with it because a lot of times you're talking to people who are, you know, 200 feet away from you.
Yeah.
Everything is full send. Like, all of it is just, like, dial it up to maximum. And it's great. It's, like, endearing and charming and lovely.
But when she says, what is Victoria doing to prove how she feels about you?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think a lot about... We tend to want to, like, date up, marry up.
Sure, yeah.
Right? But if we're in that mentality, then aren't we asking someone to date down, marry down?
No, we're trying to trick them. That's the point of lying.
It didn't even cross his mind that Victoria would need to win his affections.
Right.
He's just so desperate to get her to say yes, and I've been in that headspace. I was in that headspace for a long time. This comes down to a self-worth thing. If you find yourself pursuing someone and you think, I have to win them, I have to prove my feelings, what you're really saying is, I'm not good enough for this person, but if I could be, then I'd have worth. Once again, know your worth.
Yeah.
And if the person that you are interested in doesn't see that, it's not a you thing, it's a them thing.
Yep.
Right, you lazy dogs! Let's get young Tristan on his way home!
Ah,
yes, the hair.
It makes such a difference.
So majestic. This is pretty much what I'm trying to do with my hair, but I'm not Charlie Cox, so I can't pull it off. This is a very stereotypical montage, right? It's a training montage. He's learning how to sword fight. He's learning how to be a lightning pirate.
Yeah. Which,
lightning pirates, come on!
She's learning how to be human.
She's learning how to be human and dance and all of these things. And it's sort of a tropey way to get through stuff is to just do a montage, right? But if you do them well, they're entertaining.
Touché. I'm impressed.
And it's such a valuable storytelling technique to be able to get through a lot of time and a lot of story. And it's a uniquely movie thing.
Yeah.
This is a thing that you can uniquely do with movies, which is show one thing and then cut to a completely different thing. And this previous thing informs that thing. So you can show someone being terrible at swordplay, and then you can cut to be them being good at swordplay, and you go, ah, time has passed and they have learned.
Well, montages tend to be like all the good things all at once.
It's candy. It's basically Lisa's popcorn for your brain.
Have what we're having. You can have 2, 4, or 6 flavors a month delivered to your door. You can eat what we're having while we're doing it.
This is a custom Stardust flavor. It's blueberry lemonade.
It has got a kick.
It tastes like lightning in a bottle.
Well, and it's generally about transformation, which is transformation is something we all seek. That's the psychology of therapy. We go to therapy because we're seeking a transformation.
This is showing both of their personal growth. It's Tristan growing and it's Yvain growing.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily growing together. They're not falling in love in this montage. They're each getting to a point where they can fall in love with each other.
Right. He needs the confidence to love someone unconditionally. Yep. Because loving someone unconditionally does take confidence.
Yeah.
And she needs to understand what it is to be human.
Right.
And so we see that happening. And the thing I love most about this montage is when she's dancing with De Niro and she's glowing because she's happy.
Mm-hmm.
And then she dances with Tristan. It's like, it's so beautiful because for him, he's so used to wanting someone's love and not getting it.
Mm-hmm.
And her love for him, she can't even hide it.
Right.
You know, it's just
physically can't hide it.
It's such a great metaphor that he falls in love with a star and she shines for him. Like, I love it. It's just, it's wholesome and beautiful and all the good things. Boom, on top of her again.
Are you trying to break my leg again?
I can't risk people.
She's not telling him to get off anymore.
But at this rate, if we keep stopping,
we're making good time. Just leave it a minute.
She starts to glow.
Stop shining. You're gonna give us away.
I love that he's like,
are you tempted?
Tempted? By what?
Immortality? And say it wasn't my heart, not me, just a star you didn't know.
You seriously think I could kill anyone?
Shh.
Yeah, even if I could. Everlasting life. I imagine it would be kind of lonely. Well, maybe if you had someone to share it with. Someone you love. Maybe then it might be different.
And her glow goes out.
Come on. I think we're safe.
This is the ultimate in Mill not seeing it. Because she's literally going.
Bruh. Come on.
Like in real life, sometimes, okay, is it hard to read the signs? Sure. She's literally glowing for you and you're just...
And saying, are you tempted?
But I do think he kind of sees it and brushes it off because you could see he's noticing. He's like, okay.
I mean, maybe not that...
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know when I said I knew little about love? Well, that wasn't true.
Again, so much face. She's giving it all the face.
I've seen it. I've seen centuries and centuries of it. And it was the only thing that made
I'm sorry, I have ruined this. Like, now you're never gonna not notice that Claire Danes is just giving it all the face.
Lies, hate. Made me want to turn away and never look down again. But to see the way that mankind loves. I mean, you could search to the furthest reaches of the universe and never find anything more beautiful.
So, he's a mouse now.
He's a mouse.
Yes, I know that love is unconditional. But I also know it can be unpredictable, unexpected, uncontrollable, unbearable, and... It was strangely easy to mistake for loathing.
So, as an expert on relationships and love, how's this soliloquy for accuracy?
I'm trying to say, Tristan, is...
It's spot on.
I think I love you. My heart, it feels like...
Oh my god! This movie's so good!
So you're making a film... She's obviously just looking at a mark or looking at a person. Maybe she's looking at the actual
They might have
mouse.
Had the mouse in the cage, yeah.
But I'm sure the mouse wasn't staring at her for that whole thing.
Probably not.
So
I would assume that when they cut, the mouse is looking so intently because just off camera, they're holding some cheese.
Did you really mean what you said in the caravan?
What I... But you were a mouse! You were a mouse! You wanted cheese! You didn't... I asked you to give me a sign! Well,
and risk you being too embarrassed to keep saying such lovely things?
Is it okay to lie to your partner if you are a mouse?
Captain really whispered to me that day.
I'll cross that bridge when I get there.
Okay.
He told me that my true love was right in front of my eyes. And he was right.
Man, I was not realizing how much Tristan's story was my story till we're sitting doing it. Even when I was watching it. Like, last time I watched it, like, I didn't realize this is very much my tale.
Stardust, an autobiography.
Is it okay to lie to your partner if you're a mouse? Is that what cinema therapy has become? Alan asking me stuff that's never going to apply to anybody anywhere.
Listen, we've covered all the real topics. Sure. We got to get this stuff now.
I'll make up rules then. Yes, if you are a mouse, you have carte blanche to do anything you want.
Wow.
You can go ahead and poop on the carpet. They can't hold you accountable. They'd be like, I was a mouse.
Jonathan Decker endorsing cheating if you are a mouse.
Not cheating, but cheese eating.
Boo! Boo!
When she's like, you were a mouse.
No, just kill me. I'm dead now. I don't want to live anymore after that.
Tristan. What happened to you?
I found the star.
I can't believe you did it. Where's my star? Can I see it? Is it beautiful?
Yes.
Well, it's awfully small.
Well, that's just a little piece. A token for your birthday.
Well, then forget about the star. It's not the star that I want. You know what I want.
I do. You want to grow up? Get over yourself.
Flop.
Humphrey.
Thorn. You must have a death wish. Ah.
Humphrey. Humphrey, it's all right. She's all yours.
Henry Cavill is another Rachel McAdams. Very funny, but people sleep on it because he's pretty.
Just a measly handful of stardust.
Her vein. She can't cross the wall.
Attachments, they only last if we create them to last. If we work on them to last.
Well, you gotta, like, nurture them, right?
Yeah. Generally speaking, you may fall for somebody and think, this is it. I will never love again. and that's not true. Your capacity for love is endless. But for it to last, it has to be mutual. For it to last, it has to be reciprocal. And it has to be based on respect. I love that they keep using the phrase unconditional love. Mm-hmm. That it is based on who you really are. You don't want to actually change who you are to win someone's affections.
Right.
Because that's not going to last. Yes, improve for someone. Yes, grow for someone. But there's a difference between that and who I actually am and who the front I'm putting on.
Right.
If they don't actually want you for you, have enough self-respect to either walk away or go ahead and drop them on their back while saying, get over yourself and grow up.
I mean, you know, put a crash pad down first.
Yeah.
I'm sure just out of frame there was one.
Absolutely. What a lovely film.
Isn't this... I just love this movie. It's so great. If you haven't seen Stardust, rent it, watch it on streaming, however you can get a hold of it. It deserved to make so much more money than it did and become like a... Like, I really feel like for our generation in particular, A Princess Bride was like a cultural phenomenon, right?
Yeah,
like everybody our age can quote Princess Bride at each other.
Yeah.
And...
This deserves it.
This deserves that. Like, it's such a fun, sweet, just delightful movie.
Ian... If you're watching, and I know you are, thank you for the suggestion. This was awesome. And
thank you so much.
And thank you for backing Moonstruck, which you can watch at Telekinesis Entertainment.
Thank you for shilling for my short film. So until next time.
You want to grow up and get over yourself.
and watch movies.
What the hell is this?